is a CTV News Calgary special presentation.
The United Conservative Party is running on our record of success and economic growth because we are proud of it.
This election is about leadership and it's about trust. You deserve better.
My top priority is affordability.
Free medical, right? Like free healthcare.
Job opportunities in the future.
I'm a university guy, so trying to get those tuition fees down.
You're watching CTV News Calgary. Alberta Election 2023.
Hello and thank you for joining us for CTV Calgary's Election 2023 special coverage. I'm Tara Nelson. Welcome to our viewers right across the country and watching online. The campaign is now over and there is just 1 hour left to make your choice. Polls remain open in Alberta for another 60 minutes. There is much at stake in this election and it may be very close. There are 14 different parties running candidates in this election, but it really comes down to two parties and two leaders. So stay with us as we bring you all your election results and stories tonight. We're here until the dust settles and we can tell you who will be our premier no matter how long that takes. Now we are fortunate to have the gold standard group of experts here with us again tonight. They're going to help us with the analysis as we go through the evening. Gary Marr is president of the Canadian West Foundation. His legacy goes back to the Ralph Klein days where he was a Tory cabinet minister. Lori Williams is a political science professor at Mount Royal University. Mark Henry is the president of Think HQ Public Affairs here in Calgary. And Vashi Capellos is host of CTV Power Play and Question Period, very connected to Alberta, having covered the Alberta legislature. Thank you all for being here with us tonight. We also have a team of reporters right across the province watching the developments. They will bring us the important stories as they unfold. We're at party headquarters in Calgary and in Edmonton. We're at polling stations and we have crews right across the region. We are live on the web and you can follow the conversation on Twitter with the hashtag CTVElection. And we will bring you the results as soon as they come in. Here's how you'll be able to see them. So at the bottom of your screen, you're going to see the party standings. That, of course, is who's leading and who's elected. On the right-hand side of your screen, you will see results from all of the ridings as we get them. If you don't see your riding right away, just stay with us because we'll be cycling through them throughout the whole evening. Ian White is taking a deeper dive into some of the races and the trends that will be of interest this evening. So, Ian, let's set this whole thing up for people. Where are we at right now?
Absolutely, Tara. We're going to start with a clean slate. Here's a look at the map of Alberta.
Good evening. I'm Rob Brown. Welcome to CBC Alberta's special coverage of today's provincial election. The polls close in a little less than a half an hour from now. You can see that countdown clock at the bottom of your screen. Keep an eye on that. People across the province have been taking the time to help decide Alberta's future.
I think this is a big election. I think it's really important that we exercise our democratic voice right now more than ever.
The choices were very stark, and I thought it was really important to make sure that I had my voice heard.
Voters have been heading to polling stations since they opened at 9 o'clock this morning. There are more than 300 places to cast a ballot in Alberta, and the polls are open until 8 o'clock, so if you're in line at 8, don't worry, you'll have your chance to vote. You still have time to get there, obviously. You can check the Elections Alberta website to find out where you need to go. And of course, for so many, this is going to be a different experience this time through. We'll talk about that and how the fires are affecting things in just a second. But first, there's a change in one riding. We want to give you a heads up on this one in Rimby Rocky Mountain House Sundry. So the story here is that the folks who are running a polling station in that riding, they failed to open the doors on time. Now, when that happens, this happened at the Sunchild admin building. When that happens, there's a delay and it doesn't allow the window to be up to regulation. So they have to push things back. So this means we're not going to get results out of that riding until about 9:45-ish tonight. That's a bit different. So we'll keep an eye on that one. Isn't expected to be a surprise riding. So bear with us if you are in that riding tonight, but we'll get your results as soon as we can. Voting, as I mentioned, a bit different, though, for thousands of people who are still out of their homes because of those wildfires in northern Alberta.
Important for people to realize is there's three very distinct political cultures in Alberta. There's Calgary,
we'll watch them
Edmonton,
all play out
the rest of them.
In minutes from now, your vote about to be counted.
Elections are always about leadership. Who has the ideas, the plan, and the passion to make things better?
Danielle Smith is doing, she's just new. I'm going to give her a chance.
I am a fan of Rachel Notley.
And in a crisis, leadership matters.
We didn't know if we were going to have a home to come back to.
When disaster happens, Albertans pull together, even those you might not expect.
There's going to be a hard campaign that we still have to do, but I think these next few days we're just wanting to make sure that Albertans know that the leadership is unified and making sure that they get the supports they need.
But even record wildfires can't burn off the political polarization at a critical time for this province's future.
Many Albertans are honestly just a little bit exhausted by all the drama that we've had over the last 4 years through the UCP and the last 6 months under Danielle Smith.
The reason she doesn't want to run on her record is it was an absolute disaster.
Tonight, Albertans choose the leader they want.
And good evening. I'm Rob Brown. Welcome to CBC Alberta's special provincial election coverage from wherever and however you're watching across Canada. The polls have just closed here in Alberta. The scoreboard at the bottom of your screen, you know the drill. It's going to tell the story. It will project a seat count for each party tonight. And the key number on that graphic, you see it there at the top. 44 seats is what a party needs to form a majority government in the province of Alberta. That graphic is also constantly cycling through results from each of the 87 ridings. As soon as we get them, you're going to see your riding pop up, and it's going to repeat over and over again, every 7 minutes or so. So if you're looking for the riding, it will pop up. Stay with us. I also want to let you know that we have a separate feed on CBC Gem with simultaneous American Sign Language interpretation tonight. All right, there's the housekeeping out of the way, the facts, the figures. We're also going to make sure you're able to pull all that raw data that comes in into context. And for that, Nancy Carlson is joining us tonight. You're going to be speaking with people right across the province. You're going to have some special guests, Nancy.
Yes, we have our hands full here in this second studio. So we're going to be talking to people who know about party strategy, where winning is everything. So we are going to hear from mayors bringing a perspective from outside the big cities. We also have political experts. So welcome to all of you. Thank you so much for joining us tonight. I'm so looking forward to the conversation we're going to be having. We're also talking to voters from across the province, from the north to the south in Edmonton and Calgary. We have a virtual panel joining us. I'm really looking forward to hearing what they have to say, what they are watching tonight as those results come in.
Yeah, we're going to need to give them something to react to. And those results are expected to come in really rapidly tonight. Nancy, thank you. As opposed to maybe years past, you're used to waiting a little bit. The advance poll, a big story here. So a lot of vote already in. Jessica Ng bringing us those results as they break tonight. And those advance numbers, a lot of them, as I say, already in, they're going to be counted first.
Yes, they will. We are talking about more than 750,000 Albertans actually making their way to the advance polls. Those results are going to be coming in very quickly, and we'll bring them to you as soon as we have them. Let's take a look, though, at how Alberta looked at the last provincial election. Now, this time around, Calgary, very much the battleground, the UCP hoping to hold on to their base there, and the NDP, meanwhile, hoping to break through that blue wall. We'll see what happens this time around and what Albertans choose.
Yeah, that advance poll, as it starts to come in, will give us an early understanding of a trend, and we're going to get big dumps of data. So we're talking way more than you would see in one of those opinion polls, typically a sample of 1,200, 1,500 at the max. We're going to get these advance poll numbers in the tens of thousands right away. And as soon as we do, we'll bring them to you, and we'll start to lay the groundwork for how things are building towards that 44.
Madame, Monsieur, bonsoir. Ici Jean-Emmanuel Fortier. L'heure du vote tire à sa fin en Alberta. Les bureaux de vote ferment dans 30 minutes. Et dès maintenant, on vous accompagne pour décortiquer cette campagne électorale et les résultats. Nous allons vous présenter votre prochaine législature et votre prochain gouvernement. Bienvenue à la soirée électorale de l'Alberta.
Election day will be May 29th.
bonsoir. Rendez-vous avec l'histoire ce soir. Les Albertains vont-ils renouveler leur confiance envers le Parti conservateur uni de Danielle Smith ou bien choisir le NPD de Rachel Notley? Qui formera la 31e législature de l'Alberta depuis la création de la province en 1905 et la première élection le 9 novembre 1905. Et tout au long de la soirée, on va vous accompagner sur toutes nos plateformes, vous présenter les résultats, vous expliquer ce qu'ils veulent dire et on l'espère, qui formera le prochain gouvernement. Et avec nous sur le plateau, il y a des analystes et journalistes. D'abord, François Joly qui va présenter les résultats lorsqu'ils arrivent avec la carte interactive.
Oui, tout à fait, Jean-Emmanuel. Cette carte interactive qui est juste derrière moi, les résultats vont commencer à apparaître rapidement, donc dans une trentaine de minutes.
Et à ma gauche, Audrey Neveu, notre journaliste politique en Alberta. Vous allez analyser les résultats avec nous et nous parler de cette campagne électorale tout à fait spéciale.
Très spéciale parce que cette élection s'annonce beaucoup plus serrée que ce qu'on aurait cru il y a 4 ans, en grande partie en raison des fractures au sein du Parti conservateur uni et de l'impopularité de Danielle Smith.
Et Frédéric Boilly, vous êtes politologue, professeur de sciences politiques au campus Saint-Jean de l'Université de l'Alberta. Vous êtes un expert des mouvements conservateurs. Vous allez regarder comment se porte le Parti conservateur uni.
Oui, parce qu'après une année de turbulences politiques, le retour complètement inattendu de Danielle Smith en politique et à la tête des...
Quelques secondes de la fermeture des bureaux de scrutin à travers l'Alberta, sauf une exception dans la circonscription de Rimby, Rocky Mountain House, Sundry. On va vous expliquer pourquoi. Les Albertains ont fait leur choix. Madame, Monsieur, bonsoir. Ici Jean-Emmanuel Fortier à Edmonton. Les bureaux de scrutin sont maintenant fermés en Alberta. Bienvenue aux téléspectateurs qui se joignent à nous sur Ici RDI. Voici la soirée électorale de Radio-Canada.
That's why the United Conservative Party is committed to making life affordable by cutting taxes for all Albertans.
We'll cut the small business tax rate from 2% to zero.
We've declared a provincial state of emergency to protect the safety, health, and welfare of Albertans.
Ms. Smith, you were found to have broken the law.
It was a mistake. I'm not a perfect person. People know that. I thought I was going about it the right way.
I am running to be premier. So what I'm going to talk about... is how excited I am to lead this crew back into government and lead this province for the next 4 years.
Join us to build one of the greatest places on earth to live and work and raise our families, and we are going to fight to keep it that way, always.
Fortis et liber, fort et libre, c'est la devise de l'Alberta. Et ce soir, encore une fois, la liberté a été exprimée à travers le vote populaire pour choisir nos représentants. Après ce soir, l'Alberta serait-elle encore le bastion du conservatisme au Canada ou bien une province en profonde évolution? Baisse d'impôts, sécurité, système de santé. Ce soir, on va voir si les promesses sont résonnées auprès des Albertains, mais peut-être surtout à quel chef ils accorderont leur confiance. On va vous accompagner tout au long de la soirée sur le web à radiocanada.ca/Alberta, à la radio sur Ici Première, à la télévision de Radio-Canada en Alberta, mais également à travers le pays sur Ici RDI. On va vous présenter les résultats, vous expliquer ce qu'ils veulent dire et on l'espère qui formera le prochain gouvernement en Alberta. Et en bas de l'écran, dès maintenant, vous allez voir cette bande où c'est là que les premiers résultats vont s'afficher aussitôt qu'il rentre. Et on a plusieurs personnes sur le plateau également, des analystes et des journalistes. Il y a d'abord François Joly qui va nous présenter les résultats dès qu'ils arrivent.
Oui, dès qu'ils arrivent, et ça pourrait rentrer rapidement, ils s'afficheront sur cette carte, Jean-Emmanuel.
Et à ma gauche, Audrey Neveu, notre journaliste politique en Alberta. On va analyser les résultats avec vous et voir le déroulement de cette campagne qui était assez particulière.
Une campagne particulière parce qu'il y a 4 ans, avec la fusion...
The ballots are cast. Your votes now being counted.
As two leaders with long political histories ask for another chance to lead this province.
My name is Rachel Notley, and I am running to be your premier.
go out and knock some doors and win this.
After 29 days of promises and political punches.
You want to fight with Ottawa. You want to fight with the media. You want to fight, frankly, with your former self.
She doesn't want to run on her record. And the reason she doesn't want to run on her record is it was an absolute disaster.
We finally arrived at this moment. This is Decision Alberta. Good evening, I'm Scott Roberts from Global Edmonton.
And I'm Linda Olson from Global Calgary. Welcome to our special province-wide election coverage, Decision Alberta.
It has been a neck-and-neck race between the two leaders trying to turn the page on their political legacies, but tonight it is Albertans who will have the final say on whether it will be Danielle Smith and the UCP or Rachel Notley and the NDP. Forming government.
The polls have just closed, and we are expecting the first results in the next 10 to 15 minutes.
And you can count on us to bring you all the results and analysis wherever you're watching or listening. We are following the developments as they happen from party headquarters to key ridings.
Our coverage tonight spans the province and across all platforms on television, on Chorus Radio, and on globalnews.ca.
As we look forward to tonight's results, let's take a look back at how we got to this head-to-head battle. In the right corner, UCP leader Danielle Smith, and on the left, NDP leader Rachel Notley. Let's start with Smith, who took her first run at the Premier's job back in 2012 as leader of the Wild Rose Party. For a time, the polls look good, but she suffered a crushing defeat to the PC's Alison Redford.
Well, folks, tonight we found out that change might take a little longer than we thought.
2 years later, a political shocker with Smith crossing the floor to join the Progressive Conservatives, a party that she had sparred with for years. But the move was actually a blow to her own political career. Months later, she lost her own riding nomination and bowed out of politics for the time being.
We got Barry on the line. Barry, go ahead. Your thoughts today.
She pivoted to talk radio instead and stayed in broadcasting until 2021 when she left Chorus Entertainment, the parent company of Global News. It wasn't long until she signaled her desire to jump back into the political ring, and the door swung wide open in May 2022 when Jason Kenney announced he would step down as UCP leader. And in October.
I'm back!
Smith won the job, setting up her next chance to ask voters for a mandate. So, how did Rachel Notley get here? Well, she was first elected as an MLA in 2008. 6 years later, she'd become the party leader, teeing up one of the most stunning election results in Alberta history.
I think we might have made a little bit of history tonight.
In the May 2015 election, an orange crush swept the province, ending 44 straight years of PC majority governments, a knockout punch to the party that dominated provincial politics for decades. But it wouldn't keep them down too long. In 2019, Notley suffering defeat as the right united under Jason Kenney and the newly formed UCP. In a rare political move, Notley stayed on.
And it will be an honor to serve as the leader of Her Majesty's loyal opposition.
That is now the only Alberta premier to ever take another run at the job after being defeated. And it's all setting up a head-to-head matchup between two experienced women looking for that magic number of 44 seats in the legislature to claim victory tonight.
The leaders' political track records have been a hot topic this election, and a main issue for voters has been trust. Over the last month, both Rachel Notley and Danielle Smith have been trying to earn back the confidence of voters, promising their party has the best plan to address health care, affordability, and strengthen the economy.
Let's check in on the campaign headquarters now, where party faithful will be gathering to watch those results tonight. Our Joel Senek is with Chorus Radio host Rob Breckenridge at UCP headquarters in Calgary.
Joel, what's the mood like there tonight?
to see a doctor or to get health care at all. And that's something that I think that...
Well, she has suggested a pay-for service in the past.
Right, but at the very beginning of the campaign before the writ dropped, she did a news conference where she publicly, she guaranteed the public health care. She did the public health care guarantee is what I meant to say.
And I'm going to let you talk about that in just a second again, but I want to invite our viewers in right now to City News at 11, just after 11 anyway, and we do not have a final result just yet. We were hoping to start the show here on City News with a decision letting you know who your next premier is going to be, but instead we are still waiting. Now, while the election is too close to call, Elections Alberta explaining that, hey, there are no issues, that they're just taking their time, that they are going through the votes, counting them by hand. So that just means we're going to have to wait a little bit longer than we were expecting. So we have been seeing more and more results coming in throughout the evening, and we have those numbers for you on the screen as well. Again, these are not our final numbers. Tallies are still being calculated. At the moment, we're seeing leading or projected to win the UCP in 52 seats, the NDP in 35, but this is not over yet. We're going to dip into UCP headquarters. That's where our Courtney Terrio is standing by, and it is a blue behind you, a sea of people, a lot of screaming and yelling. It sounds like the party has already started there.
Again, that went well.
I'm going to interrupt you there, Mark. I'd like everyone to stand by just for a moment. We have breaking news. CTV News is making a major call. There you go. The CTV News decision desk is projecting a united conservative majority government. Danielle Smith will stay in the premier's office with the majority. Let's take a quick look at a breakdown of the numbers as they stand right now. So the United Conservative Party leading or elected in 52 ridings, and currently the NDP leading or elected in 35 ridings. So a potential seat change either way of 11 ridings. So the UCP has lost some seats. The NDP has picked up those seats. We have no other party who has picked up any seats so far this evening, and probably not anticipated. You're looking live at the UCP headquarters at the Big Four building. They are just getting the news. Of course, a big celebration there tonight. So let's go to our Jordan Canigan. He's in the middle of it all tonight. Jordan.
At long last, for many who have been waiting, we are getting closer and closer to the moment that those certainly with the UCP who've been watching that ticker come up time and again and hold steady over that 44 majority mark and then settle for the evening they've been waiting for and they've been hoping for. We are at that point now where the CBC decision desk is prepared to make the call. The UCP will hold on to power in Alberta. The United Conservative government will remain in government. So Danielle Smith will be going back to the legislature with a diminished caucus for sure. As we said earlier, still a decisive win. Yes, they went down in their seat counts, but they have a pretty healthy cushion compared to how close many expected it to be. You can see the reaction at party headquarters, some fist pumping going on. The CBC decision desk preparing to project, and we have that the UCP will govern this province for the next 4 years. Danielle Smith, who had a lot of baggage come into this campaign, and the NDP tried to make hay at every turn with it, she pulls it off. More than a decade after she first asked for a mandate from the public, first asked for them to send her to Edmonton as premier, and then saw the potential victory there as leader of the Wild Rose slip through her fingers in the dying days of that campaign, she finally has that mandate from the public. It's a new party. It's a relatively new party, only 4 years old plus a little bit in terms of bringing together the PC and the Wild Rose before that. But the blue wall has held tonight in spite of the NDP leading for years in the polls and a leader that certainly she acknowledged herself had imperfections. They hold on to power tonight. Elise Fonchiel, provincial affairs reporter with CBC Calgary, is at UCP headquarters down in Calgary. We heard the cheers. It's been a while. It's been a long time coming, but this trend has been holding. Relief in the room? How would you describe it?
Aussi, on n'en parlait pas beaucoup, mais c'était sa position un peu plus...
Et voilà, à 23h06, Radio-Canada prévoit que si la tendance se maintient, le prochain gouvernement en Alberta sera conservateur uni et ce sera un gouvernement majoritaire. Daniel Smith reste première ministre de l'Alberta. Allons maintenant au sujet conservateur uni. Tiffany Roquette, décrivez-nous l'ambiance.
Beaucoup d'enthousiasme. On a vu des très gros cris de joie de la part surtout des gestionnaires de la campagne du Parti conservateur uni. Tout le monde s'est levé d'un coup et est venu devant l'écran pour voir ce qui se passait et pour voir cette déclaration de gouvernement majoritaire pour le Parti conservateur uni.
Qu'ils viennent d'avoir la nouvelle, justement, l'attendait un peu. Parce que je crois que justement, les conservateurs étaient sur une autre chaîne. Voilà, c'est pour ça qu'on a pu vous annoncer ça, même si ça a pris énormément de temps. 33 élus conservateurs unis, 19 en tête, contre 18 du côté du NPD qui sont élus, 17 en tête, 52, 35. Les suffrages maintenant, 53%. Contre 44 pour le NPD, 4% pour les tiers partis ou peut-être principalement les candidats. Et voilà, la ligne est franchie. La majorité, pour obtenir la majorité, c'était 44 sièges. Nous en sommes à 52, vous pouvez le voir visuellement. Et c'est un pari remporté, pari de l'Union des droites en Alberta, pari également de Daniel Smith, malgré ses controverses, son bagage politique. Et quel retour en politique albertaine, celle qui avait trahi son parti en 2014, celle qui n'avait même pas pu obtenir sa nomination, et puis celle qui avait été peut-être une des causes de la défaite conservatrice en 2015. Eh bien, de retour, remporter une course à la direction pour le Parti conservateur uni et remporter une élection générale en Alberta avec un gouvernement majoritaire.
There's a buzz in the room right now. We can certainly feel it, Linda and Scott. We will throw it back to you.
Absolutely. Thank you, Dallas. And we do have breaking news.
And this is the moment we've all been waiting for. Here is your breaking news. Global News is projecting the United Conservative Party will form the next government, and it will be a majority government.
We now know that Danielle Smith will lead the province, making her the third female premier in Alberta's history.
And here is a live look right now as they are getting the news, at least some of the people there at UCP headquarters in Calgary. Big cheer from the crowd, as you can see. Hopefully they're watching us on Global News here, and they're just disseminating that news among the crowd there with news of the party's victory tonight. There you go.
Yeah,
a lot of happy faces in that building tonight. All right, let's go live now to UCP headquarters in Calgary for some reaction to this win.
Back to you guys.
All right, well, we have got some news that's not going to go over well to where you're reporting from there, Jillian. City News is now prepared to declare an Alberta United Conservative majority win, sending Danielle Smith back to Edmonton as the province's premier. That's seeing her take over this time with a mandate from Albertans across the province. We have a majority government. We are getting that announcement later than expected, but it's not an unexpected announcement that we're seeing here. What was it? What brought, you know, Danielle Smith out on top after such a contentious month-long campaign? Natalie, what do you think gave her the edge?
You know, I think
the UCP campaign tried to stay positive. And we've heard that. We've heard that tonight from, you know, reporters on the street, that that negativity was really weighing on people. So I think, you know, being positive and providing some great policies, particularly a tax cut for lower-income Albertans, I think those are, you know, two things that really resonated with people across the province.